Mr. Speaker, today I met with Victor Cuadras and Zaida Hernandez, two young Nicaraguan student leaders who bravely protest the abuses and violence of the Ortega regime, knowing that they could face trumped-up charges upon their return to Nicaragua. Victor and Zaida feel a unique sense of responsibility to come here to Washington to advocate for justice and liberty for their homeland. They represent the voice of the Nicaraguan people, old and new generations, who desire nothing more than a free and democratic country where one can be prosperous and live without fear of repression. What a concept. And we must listen to their pleas, Mr. Speaker. Countless of Nicaraguans are on the front lines, as you can see on this poster, confronting the brutality of the Ortega regime day after day. Over 120 Nicaraguans and one U.S. citizen have been killed at the hands of this murderous regime in just the past weeks. Over 1,000 Nicaraguans have been injured. Hundreds continue to disappear. Mr. Speaker, I was on the floor yesterday, and here I am again for the fourth time since the regime's crackdown on the Nicaraguan people began on April 18th, because I believe that it is vital now more than ever for the United States to support the people of Nicaragua in its fight to reestablish democratic order. We must let the people know that they are not alone. Earlier this week, I was joined by Republicans and Democrats, representatives and senators, in urging the administration to sanction two of Ortega's many thugs, Francisco Lopez, head of Albeniza, for laundering and corruption, Francisco Diaz, who heads the National Police, for orchestrating and the repression and the killings of Nicaraguans. But there are so many others that must be sanctioned, including Gustavo Porras, head of the National Assembly, Sonia Castro, Minister of Health, Roberto Lopez, President of the Social Security Institute, and Tirso Celedón, a real estate developer profiting from the Social Security Institute. Each of these individuals is part of Ortega's inner circle and is responsible for those acts of corruption and human rights violations, all of which have been widely reported. I urge the administration to not delay any longer and to take swift action to freeze assets, to cancel visa, and to sanction to the full extent of our laws those who are responsible for so much corruption and so many murders in Nicaragua. We have a moral responsibility to lead the way and help bring to justice those responsible for the atrocities that we see happening in that country. We need to send a clear message that the United States is paying attention, and that those terrible acts will not go up.